this week, Tracy is joined by the writer and broadcaster David Quantick. David, nice to have you with us. And what's your choice of toe curler?
Well, this is excruciating in every sense of the word. It's a single. It was a big hit in the United States for the mono-lettered singer R. Kelly. R. Kelly is not my favourite singer. He claims on this song, first of all, to have invented a genre of music called hip-hopera. Of course, two very compatible genres. One is singing very long notes in foreign languages, and the other is talking over drums. The song, to make it more pretentious, is called Trapped in the Closet, Parts 1 to 13. It's a story song in the great blues tradition, except the story is rubbish from start to finish. The story starts with R. Kelly. He's pleasured a lady who's not his wife. Her husband comes home. He has to hide, are you following me, in the closet. Her husband appears. There's a huge Barney. R. Kelly pulls a gun for no apparent reason. Then the husband's phone goes. It's his lover. The lover appears. It's a man. After another huge Barney, the man reveals he is, in fact, a minister of the church. And the song goes on and on and on. R. Kelly phones his wife. A man answers the phone. He goes home. A policeman appears who's sleeping with R. Kelly's wife. He fires a gun. He doesn't hit R. Kelly. He hits his wife's brother, who's just been released from prison. I am not making any of this up. And I think now we should all just, bearing all this in mind, listen to a little bit of the hip-hopera Trapped in the Closet.
And then she says, I say, what? She says, please sit down in the chair. And I say, no, I'm standing up. And then she cries out, I'm so scared to tell you because of what you might do. And I scream, look, girl, you better give me this man's name, and I'm not playing with you. She says, okay, wipes her nose and then asks me about a girl named Tina. I thought to myself, did it sound familiar? Then said, I probably know if I seen her. Then I said, anyway, girl, what the hell is that? She said, he know my girl Roxanne. I said, who the hell is Roxanne? Did she say Roxanne's a friend of mine? Who knows?
It's like watching 10 years worth of Neighbours in 10 minutes. It's the low point of all music for me.
Yeah, presumably somewhere in the world there's someone who heard that and went, oh, at last, a song I can relate to.